Hello, Montana. We're excited to be part of 2020's summer reading program. We are going to talk today about reptiles. We have our friends from ZooMontana here with us today. We're super excited about that. They've brought some live critters with them and are going to teach us a little bit more about reptiles and how they're not amphibians. So hang tight. We're going to switch places and teach you about reptiles. Thanks.
Hi guys, my name's Nicole Meyer. I am the education specialist at ZooMontana, and we are going to talk about why reptiles and amphibians are important. Now, reptiles and amphibians are an incredibly important group of animals for us to have in this world. One of the main reasons for this is that they provide biodiversity. Now, biodiversity means that when you have an area with a lot of different species of animals, that means that it's an incredibly healthy space. If you are in an area with only a few species, that means that only those species can live in that area. Thus, it might not be as healthy as it should. So, in order to be able to have a healthy world, the more species we have, the better it's going to be. Now, there are about over 7,000 species of amphibians in the world, and there are over 10,000 species of reptile. Those are a lot of animals, and more are being discovered every single day. But unfortunately, they do face challenges of things such as habitat loss, chemicals in the environment, and the pet trade. So the more that we can do in order to help these animals and keep those species from vanishing from our world, the better it's going to be. So that's one important, is that they just are great to have around, and they show healthy environments, especially amphibians. Amphibians are what are called bioindicators. That means that they actually show the health of the environment. The reason for this is because amphibians are very, very sensitive animals. They have skin that can actually allow them to breathe in the water. They can take oxygen through the air, through the water, into their skin, but they can also take other things through their skin as well. These could be chemicals that are in the air, the soil, or the water. And if it's very polluted in that area, you're not going to see amphibians because they're not able to survive there. So if you're in an area and you have frogs, toads, salamanders, animals like that living in your environment, that means that you have a pretty healthy place that you're living, which is great. So researchers are actually studying amphibians within various environments to determine, hey, if these guys go missing, what might be wrong with the water, the air? And the reason this is important is because things that might affect amphibians on a very low scale, at a very high scale, they could also affect us. So by studying these animals, we're able to prepare if there might be a chemical in the water that could, in the future, make us sick. So amphibians are great for bioindicators. Now, another thing that are important about reptiles and amphibians is the fact that they provide a lot of importance in the food chain. There are animals such as the frogs, the snakes, the salamanders. Everyone pretty much is at some point in the food chain and is probably going to be eaten by another animal. So those animals rely on reptiles and amphibians. Other ones are pest control. So if you don't like slugs in your garden, toads, great thing to have there. If you don't like mice in your house, snakes, wonderful addition in your neighborhood, because these guys do pest control completely free of charge and it's all organic. You guys don't have to go buy traps. You don't have to buy pesticides or rodenticides to get rid of these animals because, again, those things can harm the environment. So by having these animals doing what they do naturally, it helps us with controlling the animals around us. Now, an animal that most people usually are a little more nervous or scared of are snakes, but the thing is, snakes provide a lot of benefit to our world. If we don't want to think about it ecologically or how they benefit us within their own habitats, we can think about it as how do these animals benefit us? And that is medically. A lot of venomous snakes have very special enzymes or components within their venom that researchers are actually studying to try and find cures for various diseases. These diseases can be severe to us as humans. For example, the inland taipan is the most venomous snake in the world, but its venom is being used to try and find cures for congestive heart failure, which is something that a lot of people, especially elderly ones, have problems with. Also, their venom is being used to try and find the ability to clot blood during surgery, or if someone has a major traumatic experience where they're losing a lot of blood, they can administer that drug, which stops that blood flow and help keep that person alive. Or if you've ever known anyone who might have breast cancer, the copperhead, a snake that we have here in the United States, is actually being studied to try and find a portion of that component of its venom to try and cure breast cancer, which can save many, many lives. So within the world of medicine, snakes and other venomous and poisonous animals are incredibly valuable to our world. So it's important to keep them within our world, because maybe in the future, they could provide the next drug that could help cure that horrible disease that we no longer want in our population. So, long story short, these animals, whether they be just in the habitats or benefiting us, are incredibly vital in our world, and it is up to us in order to make sure that they remain, because they are fascinating.
Thank you! Thanks so much for joining us. We hope you learned a lot about amphibians and reptiles. We hope you come join us at the Museum of the Rockies and check out live reptiles all summer long.
Thank you also for having us, and we are super excited. Come see us in Billings at ZooMontana. This summer, there's always some fun things to do when you take a walk on the wild side.
And when you come to ZooMontana, you guys can actually meet our live animal ambassadors up close and personal, because during the summertime, we have amphitheater programs where you guys can learn about these amazing creatures. So thank you so much for joining us today. Have a great day.
See ya!